Hello, HI 101. This is American Nation One Online for the fall 2018. And in this introductory video, I will go over the course syllabus with you. And there are my office hours and my phone number and my email address. And you can also message me on Moodle. There's your course description, ladies and gentlemen. This basically goes from prehistory and the American Indian or Native American civilizations that existed before the arrival of Columbus through Reconstruction. And hopefully some of you are taking PS 110 right now as well, because this course correlates with that very well. This is your required text, excuse me. You need to go to this Norton website and sign up for an ebook. I was just on there earlier. It's $35. And once you sign up for the ebook, you will get access to Inquisitive, which is a periodic assignment. I basically give you about a month to do those assignments. They're basically due just before we take these four different exams, which are the main basis of your grade in this course. I'm not giving people any extra credit. Please don't ask. That is your extra credit possibility. Completing Inquisitive and doing any of the weekly assignments that exist. And here are the study topics. They might change up. I might move away from so many written assignments for this class, but as of right now, any written assignment pretty much will use this rubric to answer it. And this is the week-to-week schedule right now. It might change, but it's pretty much done for this semester. And you're basically going to answer all of the student learning outcomes. Just about all 15 of them you will complete by the end of the semester. And again, here you can go through this on your own if you like. It is also in the Moodle site. And make sure, if you've never taken online before, that you complete the orientation with Mr. Hunter that will tell you how to submit documents or files to the Moodle site. And this is something you're going to have to do every week. And again, this is all the different schedules. We got a bunch of days off in the fall. We basically lose about 2 weeks of work because of all the days off. October. By this date, you should have those three chapter Inquisitive assignments done. And by this date, by November 9th, you should have these Inquisitive assignments done. I give you a whole month basically to do them. And they're excellent. If you do them, you're going to learn a great deal about the course content in this textbook. It's really a great publisher feature. And we end up with those final three chapters, basically Western expansion, the Mexican-American War, then the Civil War, and the last chapter is Reconstruction. And that exam, it's not a final exam. It is basically exam four. It will be on those three chapters, and you must take that in class. And the date, time, and place will be developed by the end of the semester. Right now, we don't know when we'll be doing it. It'll be basically either on a Monday or Wednesday, I believe, because that's what this course is considered to be. Again, this is the grading system. Each exam is basically 25% of your grade. And if you do those Inquisitive assignments and chapter assignments, this will generate extra points for you. And the computer is going to automatically give them a grade. I'm using the rubric to grade many of those chapter assignments, or just a basic, simple point grading system. And that is going to be averaged in automatically by the computer. And I will round everything up. Over 5, under 5, it gets rounded down. Don't worry about the returning of assignments. They are automatically in the site. Here are your learning outcomes. We are attempting to answer these questions this semester. We're either doing short explanations or short little writing assignments where you name major issues and events, or name reasons, or you name weaknesses of the Articles of Confederation. You name the financial policies of Hamilton and so on. Right now, I have two tables developed where you will match different things in the course. Here are the program, liberal arts learning outcomes, and we basically use 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9, and 10 in this course, basically. And here are the general education outcomes, and in this course, we basically use 1, 2, 4, and 7. We don't do much oral communication, and we don't do any quantitative or scientific reasoning. And this is the curriculum trying to connect them all together. Mission statement. Well, hopefully this is meaningful education for you. Again, this helps to fulfill many of your liberal arts degree requirements, this 101 course. Please don't cheat on these exams. They're not open book. And don't plagiarize. There's no reason. These are just short writing assignments. A page, page and a half, if I ask you to write something, is more than sufficient using those different rubrics. You need to post regularly to the assignments. This is going to generate extra points for you and improve your grade. That is attending the class. Here is the disability statement. If you have any accommodations that are needed, if you need extra time to take this test or whatever, please let me know. Classroom etiquette really doesn't apply here. And if you're dissatisfied with this course, you can contact the Dean of Academic Programs, or you can go, if you're struggling, I highly recommend taking advantage of the counseling services that are available here at NMC over in Building G. Again, we've talked about what the expectations are. Successfully complete those four exams, turn in those weekly assignments and the monthly inquisitive assignments, and you'll do very well. I'm telling you, the inquisitive is a great, great publisher feature. There's all different styles of questions in that tool. Title IX, we don't discriminate on the basis of sex, and sexual harassment is a form of sexual discrimination. And if you feel you've been through this, here are your advocates. Miss Nita DeLeon Guerrero is the victim advocate here at NMC. There's the emergency phone number if you're wondering about what's going on, if we're having any sort of disasters or bad weather. Please complete this contract and print it out and try to get it to me as soon as you can. And that's just about it for this particular course. Good luck. And if you have problems, please don't hesitate to contact me.